So Teal says, hi, I need help. Cleared cache and cookies on my PC. Then I was logged out of my Microsoft Teams and Outlook. Tried logging back in. However, when I add my account, Authenticator won't generate the number that I can tap.
Lots of questions on this one.
Yeah, indeed.
Yeah. First of all, your authenticator, unless it's on your PC, should have had not been affected whatsoever by you clearing the cache and the cookies that you have on your PC. So that's number one. Second, then I was logged out by my MS Teams and Outlook. By whom? And for what reason? How? Was it just a conscious thing that you decided to do? Did somebody update something somewhere and tell you to log out so that they could do something or whatever? I mean, that's of less importance, however, than tried logging back in. However, when I add my account, Authenticator won't generate the number that I can tap. Well, is that the way it's working in this particular case? Because there are like four different ways Authenticator will get back with you. First of all, it just says, hey, I need authentication, tap this, which you can. Second way, it'll give you a series of four or five or six different numbers. You know, please tap to allow the account or number or this particular authentication request with these five or six digits, pass, tap OK to accept that. A third way, it will provide you with three different numbers up on your, with a number on your screen and say, select this number, and then the Authenticator app on your phone will provide you three or four different numbers and you pick the correct one. The latest iteration of that is that they say on the request from your PC, please enter the following number. And when you open Authenticator, you've just got a type to type in field and you can add whatever number happens to be there. So it's, and how did we get to this? Did the Authenticator ever work in the first place?
Mm. But when I hear the question, I can't help but think of the times when I've got a new phone, or I had to reset my phone, or it was damaged. And anyway, the original Authenticator account installation and the accounts associated to my installation, on the phone are gone. And so I come in with a new phone. I install the Authenticator app. I go to Teams or any other privileged access site in Microsoft 365, and it's saying I'm prompting you, but I'm not seeing it on my device. And I think we've all had that, right? And there's a linkage between those original setups of the Authenticator accounts, maybe on the original device prior to a reset or a replacement, that need to be maintained. So it's good that you cleared the cache and the cookies. That never hurts, and that usually helps. But in this case, it sounds like the issue is not Teams or your web, but your Authenticator app, assuming it's on your phone device. So question to ask yourself, did you get a new phone? If so, did you restore the accounts? And when you restore the accounts, Hal, it's not just like restore from backup. There's a bunch of other business that you have to do, right? Back on the Authenticator screens.
It depends on the Authenticator style and the site that the Authenticator is working against. For example, Facebook, GitHub, places like that. It just, if you have backed it up and you restore it, following directions, those just automatically come up and work. For any Office account, 365 account, of that sort of thing, it will come back with an error that says you need to reconnect Authenticator to this account. This is where it kind of becomes sticky, because if you've got an old phone and you were very nice and you backed up your stuff firsthand, and then on your new phone you download it all, it's still going to need you to use the old phone or some other second factor that you may have entered in order to be able to get back into your account to reconnect that particular the Authenticator with the account that you're trying to open it with. And that's where a lot of people wind up in trouble. They'll, oh, I got me a new phone, I got rid of the old phone. on, and you'll find that not only is the authenticator on that phone that they either didn't back up or did back up and are running against this error that I've mentioned, or another one of their second factors happens to be the phone number of the phone that they just got rid of and they've got a new phone, so it won't prompt them that way. Mm-hmm. An instant. So my big thing in life is give it as many different second factors as you can. I think in this case, all he really needs to do is to get back into his account and tell it this for this authenticator is connected to those accounts, to right. these accounts. I have a question of whether he has a methodology of getting back in there without his old phone, without some other second factor, an email address or mm-hmm. two or three or four, as it will take a lot of them, or yep. a phone number or two or whatever. On my Office 365 account, it's the M365 family account. But in that particular one, I've got like three different email addresses and two phone numbers, plus wow. the authenticator, plus an old authenticator. That was the thing. The wow. thing that I did when I had to replace my phone, I had, first of all, the phone that I use is no longer being manufactured. It's an LG. So anything that I'm dealing with is old. When I bought the phone, because they weren't terribly expensive, I bought a second phone thinking if I have a problem, I've got an instant backup. And that has pretty well worked. I had a case with the old phone, the first of the two of these that were the battery decided to expand. And while I was getting the battery replaced, I needed the second phone. Well, I had them both set up. Authenticator actually works because of the way I'm guessing the way that they set it up. If you go back in and you can have more than one authenticator defined on a program. Now, I've not been an occasion yet where one phone was dead and I needed to fire up the other phone to get back in. So I don't know specifically if that works, but I can very much attest to the fact that on a 365 account, I have got two different authenticators. Mm. And I know at least in part that works, because for some of the other the ones that I don't have to go back in and reset, I forget whether it was Facebook or GitHub or whatever, if you look at the two of them with both phones turned on and running, they're producing the same number. So there's again, I've got more questions than answers on this particular question.
Mm. Yeah, I've never been able to relink my Office 365 account to my authenticator without either having the recovery information put in ahead of time or working with my IT support team to reinitialize the prompt.
My advice for Teal is, it sounds like not able to do it, maybe didn't have those backup authentication methods. Your only option is talk with IT and get that reset.
And pray that it's not an outlook.com, because you'll never get there. If it's a 2FA setup account and you lose the second FAs and can't get back in, you are dead. That account is gone. It is history.
Yeah, we've talked about that in past questions as well. Not to scare you, Teal, but yeah. Well, that's why, I think we've made it clear is to have multiple backups, emails, other methods, other multiple factors. Yep.
Henceforth, I shall be called Fuchsia.